Hey there, guys.
Today, wanted to touch on the past versus the present. The 20th century versus the 21st century. It's so interesting how things almost sometimes go in a cycle, and however, at times there's new change, and change is something, whether we like it or not, we have to adapt to. Some of the change we can be optional, but even the optional change at times becomes compulsory to adhere to. Just was thinking about my topic, this one, and I thought, what can I give us examples? So just think about it. What was the things that basically we looked forward to or we enjoyed back in the 20th century, or how our life was in 20th century? First thing I'll start with possibly in there is the enjoyment people felt with regards to tobacco smoking. Was a social thing, very prevalent in males and females. It was something that was seen, as a pastime in the earlier to mid 20th century. And then you had fast food introduction after the Second World War with McDonald's, especially in the 50s, and then the rest of them coming on. But what, how that was looked forward to by people. The kind of like meanings that were attached to it, the change of life, the change of time, the life getting faster, and people looked forward to it until a time, and then you had the introduction of canned foods back in the 70s, and that showed the speed of life that just keep gathering. And it's interesting, but it was the second part of the 20th century where it really kind of like started to pick up, the pace at which people were living all around the world. And you had a boom in the manufacturing industry all the way through most of the 20th century, barring probably the last 10, 15 years where things started to kind of like saturate in some senses, and service industry started to take over. And then you compare it to just after the tide of the turn. One other thing I was going to mention, which was a big trend back in the later part of 20th century, which is globalization. People really looked forward to the fact that the world was just one global village, that you had European Union coming together, and SAARC up in Southeast Asia, and so many different unions that were created out of trying to make the world one place for everyone. And then you had this change come through the 21st century where, firstly, later part of the 21st century, 20th century, and then, straight away into the 21st century, tobacco was frowned upon. It was interesting how the times changed. The more people were aware of the fact that the losses, or the side effects to, with the health and everything, people really kind of like started to, almost give a lot of thought to their bodies, their health. I mean, getting into it, you now, getting organic foods that were a big earlier to, it's early 21st century when it all started, but the movement is just more and more. Today, people aspire to the organic food thing. People don't want to hear GMO. And then again, GMO was one of those things that was just a big invention or big discovery of 20th century. And then, the most modern thing at the moment is the fact that people are really looking at sugar, as being one of those big bad devils. And even though how much people, between up till this point, I mean, the amount of sugar we use is unbelievable. Being from a personal trainer background as well, I know how detrimental that is, and trying to keep my family kind of to some extent away from it. But you have sugar, basically. It's something that's staple, and now people are getting more and more aware of its losses. Then you've got the service and cyber industry. Service industry has really taken over. The banking is a big thing. Monetary policy and how basically that goes on, and how people kind of like aspire to that. And at the moment, the economy and how governments kind of like really take a big thing about, trying to regulate policy through money. And then you've got the lastly, what have I got up here? People reverting back to you have nationalism. the big thing that's just happened with the Brexit, you know, coming out of EU. And at the moment, they're saying because of that one move, there might be a domino effect where people are going to get out of the European Union, the countries are going to come out, and it's becoming a real, real challenge for them to kind of like try and reverse that tide and sell people to that one community idea again. So, you know, keeping all of this in mind, I mean, what I want to get to is, it's like Bob Proctor, great man, I mean, great life coach, who talks about the fact that the 21st century and beyond will belong to the people who will learn, unlearn, unlearn, and relearn. And that's the key, isn't it? It's like the kind of things, the supposed things that are meant to be beneficial to humans when they come about, and then you've got to accept the new discoveries, the changing times, and then what that basically brings to life. And that's where guys, we gotta really concentrate on what kind of economies we're living in, and then tying that up into the changing of the whole our lifestyles, the introduction of so much more technology, and again the cyber economy, and look at it, all of this, guys, and then it ties back into the fact that that it's so imperative to change. And that was my point, you know, comparing just the 20th century to 21st century, that life has gone so fast, and the only people who will inherit the earth will be the learners. And that's what Bob Proctor basically summed it up as. So keeping that in mind, guys, what I'm going to share with you, a few links up there, there's a few free knowledge workshops. Get yourself signed up to them. There's going to be, if they're in your area, get down to them. Really learn what you don't know, discover what is the new change, and get with it, guys. Get with it, get on to it. Leave me a comment, you know, tell me what you think about this video. Really great connecting. God bless you all. Take care.